Alright, I told you we need at least 8, right? We have a 4 concentrate and 4 distilled water. You see? Distilled water. Because we don't need electricity passage over there, you know, on the block. So we need at least in total 8 gallons to empty and fill all the system, right? Both systems. We have the main system right here. Alright. And we have the secondary system right here. Alright. We are going to do both. Alright. One thing to know is, I don't know why, but some Ford dealer doesn't have an orange one, only yellow one. But they say no problem, you can use empty all the system and use yellow one. If rest, you know, still have some orange coolant inside, don't worry about it. You can mix with no problem. Alright, so we will be yellow one. So for the main system, where is the drain plug? Right here on the driver side front, you will see this drain plug over there. Alright, I put, you know, hook a hose to let it dry into a container. Alright, so there is the main drain plug, right? But after drain, that system over there, also you have to drain the block. So for the driver side, what I did, I removed the hose from the motor oil cooler. Right, the motor oil cooler is right here on the driver side, so left side and the block. So I removed the hose. I remove this hose from the motor oil cooler. Alright, so I remove the clamp, move back, and then release this hose right here. So I collect more from here. But now I am going to do on the passenger side. For the passenger side, there is no a cooler like this. So for doing the passenger side, I am going to remove the heater, block heater. Okay, there is a connector and a heater over there. But I think maybe it's not necessary. All you need maybe this do is this right here on the driver side, the cooler, not on the passenger side, because you need more tools, more skills to do that. But we'll see. It depends how much coolant coming out from that side over there. Alright, so if coming out more than half gallon, oh yes, I recommend do that also. So let me go to the other side. So we are here on the passenger side. Remove this splasher right here a little bit, and over there you will find, you know, the engine block heater. Alright, so there is, so I'm going to remove that one. I unplug the connector, it's an orange connector, you saw it, you know, it's under that. But I want to know how much coolant will come out from this hole right here. So from that, it depends if you need to do that also or no. There is a plug, you know, a drain plug somewhere. It's hard to see. There is, you know, you can see a little bit the drain plug, but it's hard to take it out because the starter motor is there. So I don't think it's necessary. So let me remove this heater right here. You will see how much coolant will. You can cover them, the starter with something. It's okay, you know, just in case. Let me try to put there, you know, something. Something.
Maybe a plastic box?
I don't start it. I don't think it's very important, but yes, we can protect the starter. Okay, there is a plastic bag over and around the starter. So now I'm going to remove this here. Oh yes, I recommend remove this here. There was a lot of coolant, maybe more than half gallon. Alright, so yes, you have to remove this here. Yeah, but you need to remove this thing from place. The first thing, you have to disconnect the connector, the electric connector. All right, it is a orange wire, but apart that, you will need the socket. These are 32 millimeters. 32 millimeters. I use a short extension, you see, and also a hard drive ratchet. We need the ratchet, but not only the ratchet, we need something bigger. We need this bar, and from the barrel with the extension and with the 32 millimeter socket, you can remove that thing. All right, so it will help. Let a lot of coolant coming out from the system, so now I can put everything back in my system, the main system, is ready to fill it up. Then I have to go to the second system. All right, the secondary system, the plug for the secondary system is right here, somewhere right there, right here. Okay. Also, I can hook a hose right here and remove the drain plug and let the system drain. Oh, before drain, you have to, what can I say? You have to remove the cap, the radiator cap, both sides. And then there is another cooler, but this is for the transmission fluid, right? So also, we need to remove this hose right here for the transmission cooler. Remove the hose and collect most I can, because it will hold a couple more ports of coolant. So this is all you have to do for the secondary system. Alright, you see how much coolant do I have? Yes, I am planning to collect that. Also, I have to replace something right here, because there is a Google dial, something like that. The steering wheel start to shaking after hit a bump. But I think I have to replace this thing right here. It's a little bit loose. Moving, so yes, I plan to replace this part also. It's rust right here, but we need a lot of WD-40 or something else, and we'll see how are this joint right there. It's not a joint, it's a joint for this bar right here and that bushing over there. All right, I'm not sure about this one also. Probably do I need to replace it. All right, so After take it out all the coolant from the system, close all you open and refill it. All right. The secondary and the primary circuit. All right. And the way to do the service on the coolant on this Super Duty diesel truck. All right. Thank you for watching this Arontir Diagnostic Pro videos. Have a beautiful day. Bye bye.